when it comes to the scale and intensity of wildfires, it's growing out of control. Palisades fires, Australian brush fires, Turkey, the Amazon.
The impact of losing those biomes is staggering. It's hard to conceive. The future that we see for Pyri is that any wildfire that starts can be detected in seconds.
Early warning systems, it's the same reason that you want to catch cancer early before it's too late. Prevention is always better than recovery.
Forests are absolutely critical to society. Without forests, we would not have clean drinking water. We would see many more devastating floods. The air that we breathe would be much more toxic. And in the end, forests provide the oxygen that we need to breathe, function, and to have a prosperous society.
Wildfires cost the U.S. economy about $400 billion to $900 billion. They are not only a threat to our planet and our climate, but also to our economy.
The fires are hotter, faster moving, and more destructive than they've ever been in maybe the history of this landscape.
The UN put out a report back in 2023 that states that by the end of 2050, we're going to see a 25% increase in the intensity and frequency of these types of large-scale, impactful fires, especially in places that have never experienced fire before.
When you talk about tropical forests, the Arctic Circle, regions that are very vast and currently underserved for the current technologies. Imagine putting cameras all over a forest, a big forest. It's not that easy to maintain or easy to implement either. I'm Richard, I'm CEO of Pyri.
I'm Blake Goodwyn, and I'm the CTO of Pyri. Pyri is a scalable, accessible wildfire detection system. It's based off a sensor that we've developed that uses novel organic electronics to turn the heat from an incoming fire into a detectable radio signal. We can use networks of these sensors to essentially track where a fire is in real time, its spread, its speed, and with confidence know exactly where it is. The sensor can be dropped into remote regions from aircraft, such as a drone or a helicopter, and when a fire occurs, the pod activates and sends a radio signal.
The breakthrough idea behind Pyri is its scalability, at the same time being affordable. Because we are using organic materials, organic electronics, we managed to create a sensor that's much, much, much cheaper than the most of other standard technologies that exist in the market. And because of that, and because it's not toxic to nature, it allows us to scatter them through vast forests without causing any pollution.
So technologies within the early warning space are things like satellite imagery, camera systems, ground-based sensors. The technologies in this space have been developed for other things. They're very conventional, they're very broad scale. Even with the most advanced satellite systems we have to date, you maybe get an image every 20 minutes. Conversely, camera systems on the ground and ground-based sensors are really expensive to deploy.
By using abundant organic materials in nature and adapting them to the current process that we have, we managed to make something much more affordable. The idea that we had for Pyri, design a solution that's not just to protect or be guardians of nature, but a design for nature, through nature. Those both together create the biomimicry concept and idea that we had for Pyri.
Biomimicry is innovation inspired by nature. It's in practice, it's when you're about to design or invent something, you say, what in the natural world has already done what I'm trying to accomplish? Homo sapiens are a relatively young species. We've been here about 200,000 years. But the rest of life, the rest of nature has been here 3.8 billion years. And in that time has learned to do everything we want to do without harm to the planet.
Nature is 100% the ultimate designer. Is the best inspiration that we can have, super specialized for whatever challenge that exists.
And in developing Pyri, we looked at some biological systems that exist within the environment, specific organisms, as a means of, okay, is there a pathway forward here?
We start to look for more than 600 seeds and their shapes and how they are dispersed and how we could maybe take that as inspiration for also design Pyri, a solution that needs to be dispersed in nature as well and stay there. We start to look, for example, how different biomes deals with degradability and how Pyri can be used on that biome as well and how that could help us trigger the heat and trigger the system altogether.
Of course, it would have been easier to use off-the-shelf products, off-the-shelf materials, but by using these organic materials, we actually circumvent a lot of the polluting, energy-intensive processes that are already established within this space, not to mention the cost. We plan on scaling Pyri through a number of pilots that we're planning for next year. We have functional prototypes of our system that we'll be demonstrating in the field and throughout the remainder of 2025, and then doing a number of these pilot tests to show and to derive how the system works in different biomes, how it's going to work in different deployments and under different conditions.
For example, if we already have a firefighter helicopter in the region, we can just use that helicopter to scatter them as they were like seeds. But if they don't have, we'll have our own drones that can do the same service as well. The key here is to scatter as much Pyri as possible in a very vast area as quick as possible as well. Generate that integration and also detection network early for those communities.
So we're looking for commercial partners around the world that are willing to say, we have a wildfire problem. We know we're going to have a wildfire problem and we want a solution in place.
It doesn't matter if it's a rich country or it's a country that is still developing that network. It's affordable for everyone.
And what gives me hope is the younger generation. I'm seeing the youth across the world stand up and say, our future depends on healthy forests and we will be part of the solution. And they're going to lead us where we need to go.
With all of the rapid changes we're seeing now from climate change, from the advent of forest fires around the world, I think a lot about the environments that I grew up in, the natural places that mean so much to me and how much they can change and how much they have changed in the previous decades.
When I was younger, I could see, especially in Rio, there were regions that we could see the fire destroying a whole area, a mountain, for example, and how it was tough for the firefighters or for the community to protect the region or just to respond to that. And then as I start to grow up, I start to see also in the other regions and biomes, like in Pantanal, completely being destroyed as one of the richest biomes in the world, and then losing everything.
For me, I've seen enough. I've seen enough communities burn over. I know enough firefighters that have lost their lives. I've counted so many dead giant sequoias. I've seen forests that are never going to come back. For me, I've already seen enough.
If we don't integrate the value of nature into our economic systems and into our financial systems, we'll have a huge blind spot that will enable us to continue degrading nature and losing nature rather than protecting and restoring it.
The vision for Pyri, I think, is going beyond wildfire. The technology that we've developed here has potential in all sorts of environmental sensing where that sensor has a risk of never being recovered. But at the moment, in the current climate crisis that we find, wildfire is an issue that this technology can serve best. So by tackling wildfire and proving ourselves there, we see that as a way of saying this is a technology that can unlock all sorts of environmental intelligence the world over.